Check. the NFL on EA Sports. Chargers going up against the Egyptians. So the time has come. Let's send you out to the stadium and join the two men that will have the Super Bowl call. Here are Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Larry, we find ourselves right in the center of the Dallas-Fort Worth Metroplex in Arlington and AT&T Stadium. We come down to kickoff of what should be an epic one here between the San Diego Chargers and the Memphis Egyptians. Anticipation here as the D-line sandwiches together. They're on the counter now on first down. And we'll take this one up close to the 25-yard line. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and eight. The starting lineup for the Chargers of San Diego. Who are we discussing out of this unit, Charles?
A big guy out of Arkansas. Their tight end, a second-round pick, Hunter Henry. Many people had a first-round grade on him. Plays the best tight end coming out of the draft. Has the ability to get down the middle of the field, get into the seams, and knows how to find dead space against the defense and create plays.
Here we go now. Blue 45. Black 58. Oh.
They run it now. Here we go. Right inside, but nothing there. Officially no gain in the play, and they're left with a third and eight. And let's look defensively at the starters.
Kuechly is absolutely amazing. Maybe the best middle linebacker in the game. Not only is he cerebral, this guy's athleticism is off the charts.
An early tough test on the opening drive. This is third and eight. Throwing his balls on third down. And a throw right side is complete. And they talked about how important the passing game is going to be against that defensive look. Good job there going to the air for the first down.
It's all about preparation. It's all about planning. Then it's about execution. So put it all together in practice. Okay, this is what we think we're going to see. This is how they get to it. And then when the game comes, read it and attack it. I like it. I like it. I like it. Get everyone involved in the passing game. And you know you create those great mismatches throwing it to your guys out of the backfield.
And on the first drive, that can also help establish some rhythm, right?
I think so. It gets everyone involved. They feel like they're part of it. It really gets them amped up as they go forward.
So the offense readies for a second and four. He's going to be stopped in his tracks at the line of scrimmage. They'll lose a yard at that time, and that's going to lead to a third down. So third and five, defensively expecting pass. They've got six DBs out there. As he releases it, and now fall incomplete.
Pressure on the guy throwing the football is always good, but when you can couple that with contact on him that leads to an incompletion, as we just saw there, that's winning football.
Here's Garrett Swanson now. As the first drive of the game stalls out, he's on to punt.
Detroit!
safeties.
Patrick,
then moves him up to outside linebacker to combat the spread offenses. And now we're seeing it in the NFL. Those same guys using their speed to make plays in the backfield, similar to that one.
And able to get a little more breathing room out to the 5-yard line. It'll be a 3-yard gain, and that'll make it third down. And when this offense is clicking on all cylinders, the running back is in sync as well.
The focal point. Runs, catches, blocks, sets the tone for the offense.
Tough spot for the offense. Third and 8.
Back effort. Let's go.
From deep in their own territory, they look to throw.
They would have taken it if they could have gotten it. But to give their punter a little bit of space and try to help out the defense.
And that's a safe completion on third. you see defensive holding. Here it's offensive holding for the flag. They'll put two receivers left, two to the right.
Eighth, eighth. Black 58, rail. Black 58, rail. Close, close, close. Eighth, eighth. 390. 390.
They'll run it now, out of the gun. And a pickup of about four down inside the 10 to the 8-yard line.
And there's a run to be happy with. Good, solid yardage. They'll take that any time you hand the ball to a back.
Close.
Shift together here from the D-line. Throwing on second down. Looking right sideline, but it's incomplete.
Let's give some credit to the defensive guys on that play. Able to bat that one away. Show them that they're trying to hit the corner route.
This will be play number eight on the drive. It's third and goal.
There we go.
Ball's now on third and goal. Finding time. Force that to his left. He can run for it, and he will. He'll get a couple yards on that one, and that's going to make it fourth down.
Well, partner, nothing comes open here, so he decides to skate out of there, and he doesn't pick up a first down, but does gain additional yardage to set up a possible field goal attempt if they decide to go that route.
Chargers grab themselves a 3-0 lead. And we were scoreless up until this point in the second quarter. Now we finally have a little action.
Let's see where this action takes us. First quarter, no points at all. Now we've got our first score of the game. Well, does that signal that we're going to get more as we go along? Or will it revert back to what we saw in the beginning of the game?
And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. Now this offense ready to take over again. Certainly be trying to do better than that first drive where they went 3-and-out.
And sometimes the first drive is just simply to settle nerves. You know what it's like at the start of a game with the emotion, guys a little bit jumpy.
You
understand the same way. Just like us calling one, right? Making sure we ease into the game, let it come to us.
Well, you
opportunity. No, you didn't go 3-and-out. I went 3-and-out. Just what you want on a first down run. Call it 8 yards. Second and two.
I know the toss play begins with the guy taking the snap and turn around and tossing it to the runner. But where the real intrigue is, can they seal the edge? Whether it's an offensive tackle or a tight end in the direction they want to run the football. If they do that, that's the result that you get, that type of a game. If they don't, oftentimes it's not a very successful play.
They come out with one back and three tight ends. They stay on the ground. This is Marshall again. And he'll be brought down right around the 37. There's 4 yards on the pickup, but that's good enough to extend the drive.
But we always talk about good down and distance allowing offenses to expand their playbook. But second and two, that means your playbook's wide open. You can run just about anything. A lot of times, the play caller, he just looks down at his sheet, sees the short yardage runs, and goes to one of those.
So the run gets him the first and the play with a fresh set of downs. They come up in an offset. This is Marshall. And able to get this one all the way up to about the 46-yard line. A nice run there, 9 yards, and it'll be second down.
Some runs are blocked so well, you almost forget that someone has to carry the ball to gain the yardage. The leverage by the offensive line to create space up front, really well done.
Leopard, second down, just Leopard, 1 yard
no,
to
no,
go.
Check, Patriot, Patriot! Hurry up, here we go. Great!
They'll run with Marshall. And he'll be brought down just shy of midfield at the 49-yard line. 3 yards there, good enough to keep the drive moving.
Second and one, if people want to run the football, this is what every back in the league is supposed to do, exactly what we just saw there. Pick up the first down.
All right, here we go.
Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it. And for right side here, complete. 15 on that one. And that'll be good enough for the first.
Everything about that play was beautiful. A great corner route with the receiver. Worked the defensive back inside and then worked back to the outside to the corner. But how about the throw by the quarterback? Anticipation on the break from inside to outside. He threw the football as the receiver turned around. The ball greeted him.
And here's Marshall. Down to 30 after a gain of 3. And brought down there by Mira Chargers on the snap.
Well, so far this game has gone the way the defensive coordinator had hoped. They've dictated things. They've not let them run the ball very well at all. They gave up a nice game there. I doubt it'll back off their confidence. They've played so well throughout this entire game.
Six yards here to go for the offense on second down.
Now let's go!
Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. As he throws there, incomplete.
The big signal calls will never go back in the huddle and play the blame game because they need those guys to protect him. But on that last one, his offensive line, they lost their leverage very quickly, and that's why they're able to get to him and hit him as he tried to throw the football and force an incompletion.
Seventh play of the drive upcoming here on third and six. Five wides in the game. Four of them to the right side. On third down, he'll drop to throw. And a double coverage and it's intercepted.
Situations, trying to ice a game, that sort of deal. Most of the time, it's end zone, and that's what you're thinking.
Three, 90,
I believe that's exactly what they're thinking as they begin this one.
Yeah, no quarterback ever been top position.
Let's get through here.
Not one more. 15 yards on the pickup there, and the Chargers are going to have the first down.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
Three, 9,
they go play action here on first down. Got hit. Ball pops out, incomplete.
Everything looked right on that play except the conclusion. He dropped it. An in route, going into a little bit of traffic. Maybe in the back of his mind, he was wondering where the hit was going to come from.
Second down now after the incompletion.
There we go. Green, now up.
On play action. Now Bortles. And right side, Henry's got him. And he'll be brought down right around the 37. And they'll get 9 there as that sets him up better for third down.
So much goes into a successful play, doesn't it? How about that play action there? Freezing the defense just enough to bring the tight end free downfield for the completion.
So here we go, a third down after the second down pass completion. Brief break in the action here. We'll come back on Super Bowl Sunday after this.
Here we go now. 339. 339.
Bortles to throw on 31.
Catching the ball, timing it up with the quarterback. Are my feet going to get down inbounds? On that play, all those things going through his head, he's called to drop it.
This is away and a very good kick angled for the sidelines. And this will be out of bounds at the one here. The 12-yard line. So now comes the offense and on the field. Looked like they had something going last drive. Then the interception happened. Will they recover?
Something going. They were moving the ball on offense, had a nice sequence going. Don't worry about the other part. You can't get that back. Let's go back to what you were doing well before.
I thought you were going
to
say they need
Patriot.
Over.
Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. And he's got it. Just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. So the offense has it first and 10. The defensive line disperses a little bit here, maybe expecting a pass.
Let's go!
Back to throw now on first down. They come out five wide, three of them to the right side.
No. Check, Patriot! Detroit! No. Check, Patriot! Watch it now, Barney!
They'll look to throw now on first down. It's complete. Nice gain of 21 yards. Well, we know he's got the speed there. He needed the speed and the hands. A great catch.
And because of that speed, you have to respect it as a defender. So you have to either play off or make sure you're somehow in contact with him. And he's able to do exactly what you said. Use the speed to his advantage and go up and get the football. That's a big-time play right there.
Hurry up, here we go!
And he'll end up losing yardage here back at the 21-yard line. It's a loss of four there, bringing up some... And the Chargers are going to look up here and signal for a timeout. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime.
Hurry up, here we go!
They look to throw. And he will find his man on the outside. That catch good for five. It's third down. Still in search of the first down after that last completion.
Hurry up, here we go. Blue landed. All right, now you have it. Over.
They'll give it to him right up the gun. Another inside. And now the Chargers are going to signal for another timeout. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime.
How many offenses have we talked to that say we have to finish drives? Thus far, this team hasn't finished it quite the way they wanted to.
And the Chargers coming out of the field now. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense. They have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
Incomplete, but I don't know how much of that falls on the quarterback. He was pressured.
Brandon, the rush showed up so fast, the quarterback had no chance to get the ball downfield.
So incomplete on first. Let's see what second down has in store. Possible run anticipation. Here's the D-line sandwiches together. Bortles again here on second and 10. He's got his backfield. That's complete. 17 yards that time. Is that a move to change? Looking to speed things up here, going with some tempo. Bortles now on first down. He's going to flip right out here to his running back. 18 yards on the pickup there. And it'll give the Chargers a first down.
We can talk all we want about football being a game of strength and brawn. It's also a game of mismatches, and they're trying to create one there. Getting it to their back out of the backfield to make a bigger play.
As we often say, get it to him in space, let him use his leg.
Yeah, if he can get a matchup against a linebacker, maybe the defense again dropping out the zone blitz, he's going to win that battle just about every time. In recent years, the slot receivers really gained stature in the NFL because they could do so many things. Yes, they can line up rough like your normal wide receiver, but to have that kind of courage and toughness.
Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward. So with two ticks left here in the half, on is the field goal unit. Made his first. This now from 32 yards out. And his kick is good. And that will do it for this first half. So we've arrived at halftime here in Super Bowl 57 as we send you over to our headquarters in Orlando where we check in with Larry Ridley for our EA Sports Halftime Report. So both teams have their marching orders and we'll get going again here in quarter number three. And now back out comes the offense. They're down here, but very much in this game. What's the tonality of a coach's talk when a game is within striking distance like this at intermission?
Typically, what they're doing is emphasizing the things that went well in the first half and wanting more of that. Sure, you've got to go over some of the errors and clean up some things because there's a reason you're down. But overall, I think they want to stay positive, stay up with this team. We're just starting the second half.
Here we go.
Then we've got the football. Let's go ahead and punch it in. We're going to take it from
there. See how that recipe works. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down.
Abandoning things during a game. But here we are in the second half. I think it's time to change things up. Let the running game go a little bit. Let's get to the passing game. And if you still want to get in the hands of the runner, maybe you swing it to him, throw it to him a little bit. Try it that way.
Now let's go. 3-19.
Now a shotgun snap as they look to throw. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down. Pretty good coverage there in both of these defenses. They've had good coverage throughout this one.
No doubt about it. And in today's NFL, where we're used to a bit more scoring, this feels almost like a well-pitched game in baseball on both sides, where the tension continues to build. Who's going to make the big play?
And some changes here as the D-line separates some. Third down, he'll drop to throw. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Joey Bosa in there again, and that's sack number 12 for him on the year. He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. Fielded at the 33. He should have caught it. He's averaging just under 50 yards a punt as he gets this away. A 37-yard punt, maybe a couple on the return. watching the switch here as this offense will come on deep in their own territory. Now this offensive unit ready to see what they can do here. And on the last go around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to come from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. Now Marshall. Give him 11 on the game there, and that'll give him a first down.
So much for him being bottled up throughout the day. Finally finds a way to break through and get a really nice game. The defense has felt great about what they have going. Now they've got to turn their attention to getting it back in that direction. Can they bottle him up again? Because confidence is pretty high for
him. And they've got one game here in the tailback. Now he will lose yardage and be backed up to the 24. That's going to go as a loss of two, and it'll be second down. Face a second and 12. They're going to look to throw. And this one's incomplete. To go on third down.
Let's go! Bang it!
So the D-line's going to spread out. Off the play fake. He'll look to throw. And a diving grab. I think he got that. Yes! A gain of 26 on the third down of conversion.
When the spotlight is at its brightest, and let's face it, it's the Super Bowl. Those types of plays come out, don't they?
Absolutely. A big-time catch on the biggest of stages.
Do you think that one's going to live on? We're going to see this for a long time.
Definitely going to live on forever with him, that's for sure.
No doubt.
Hurry up, here we go!
They'll let it now, out of the gun. He'll be taken down right around the 41-yard line. A good run there on first down, and it'll leave him with a second and two.
This drive is turning into an extended one, and the guy carrying the ball, he's becoming more like a body blows guy. Every carry is putting some damage on the defense. After a while, I'm not too sure how many guys are going to want to run up and tackle him.
That's complete. A good pick up there, 26 yards. A great job pulling that one in from a guy, as we know, who can really blaze. He's got a lot of speed.
And that speed can work for him so many different ways. Sometimes he just takes off and goes, just runs past people. Sometimes you get people to back off so far that you can catch everything underneath. But still, at some point in the game, you probably have to make some contested catches, right? Sometimes you have to go up and beat a defender for the football. He has that in his arsenal as well.
Showed it right there.
So fast, and I think if the running back even had time to notice if anyone was there, it was just a blink of an eye, and there was a loss on the play.
Hurry up, here we go! Through, landing!
He'll look to throw. He'll try to set up the screen, it's complete. Nothing on the screen that time, now it's third down. So nothing there on the screen that time.
Because you have to try and influence them. Make them think that you're doing something else. Make them think that they can get to the passer by letting them by him and setting up the screen and getting downfield. Didn't happen at all. Give a lot of credit to the defense for not tumbling to that one.
Ninth play of the drive coming up, and certainly not an easy one on third and long.
speed limits out there, and off he went. Glad I wasn't the one trying to chase him.
Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. Now the Chargers offensive unit ready to see what they can do here. And they're coming off a three and out, my friend.
I think they've got to look at that play sheet and go to a spot that they haven't found before. Time to shake things up a little bit to try and get this offense moving.
Okay, so how do you do that? How do you shake things up?
You look at what you called before, realize it hasn't worked.
Go to something else.
Maybe you try and find one of those special plays from one of your better players, and maybe try and hit something big and get things going in the excitement area.
And nearly picked off there, and it would have been a great time for their first pick. Instead, it's second down. Second down here after the incomplete pass.
Here we go now. Green, 90. Z.
Back to the air on second down. It's Bortles. He turned it loose. It's incomplete.
It looked like they had something there, but I think that he was thinking about running with the football before he actually hauled it in, and that led to a big drop.
Second and nine.
56.
Hurry up, here we go.
56.
All right, now. Lock it 56. Lock it 56.
In motion comes the tight end left. That'll switch it up here and look to throw. That's complete. A nice pick up there at 11 yards, and it'll move the sticks. A nice little connection there on the corner route.
The receiver set it up perfectly, worked his way inside, and then broke it back to the outside for the completion.
Let's go!
They'll run it now, out of the gun. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four. The fourth quarter here, they've got the lead. They want to keep it on the ground. That's what they're doing.
Smart football. Keep the clock grinding. Keep it going. But you got to figure now, they're going to see more people stacked up at the line of scrimmage as they try and bleed it out.
Second down following the
over,
run.
Over, over, over.
They come up in an offside.
Here we go now. Boom, right now. Lock it 56. Lock it 56.
They give to the fullback on the dive, and he'll be brought down at the 45-yard line. The gain of four that time as the drive continues.
How about that call handed to the big guy in that situation? Normally you think of him as a real short yardage runner, but in this case they trust him to get a few more yards than that. I remember an old New York Giants quarterback, a Super Bowl winning quarterback, telling me he loved offensive coordinators who call the plays with a little bit of abandon.
And here comes play number six on this drive. They were just manhandled at the point of attack.
They could pretty much call them all out, couldn't you? Almost by name, right? That was a very tough sequence for the offensive line. But how about that defensive front creating a new line of scrimmage and creating a large yardage possibility?
Catch a break and get off the field.
Hurry up, here we go. Leopard! Leopard!
They'll give it to him right up the gun. Looking for a cutback lane, but nothing there as he's met at the line of scrimmage. And brought down there by a pair of Chargers on the stop.
Well, didn't make headway on that one. There's a plenty of carries all night long. This one maybe is a little bit tired from taking the rock that much.
Quarter, 2-minute warning about to hit, and it looks like they're going to get one more play in. It'll
be interesting to see what they try and do on this play. Do they try and take a shot, or do they just try to get to the 2-minute line?
2 yards on the pickup there. We're back to perhaps crown a champion after this. And his kick is right there. It's good. And that'll open the lead up to a touchdown now at 13-6. So, Charles, I think from a defensive perspective, you have to look at that field goal there and consider it a win.
You're able to keep them within a touchdown, so no question about it. That was the kind of stand that keeps you in ball games.
And now San Diego getting set to go. Now it's a third and four situation for the offense.
All right, here we go. Boom,
they'll give it to him right off the gun. No gain there on the play, and that's going to leave him with a third down. And play is stopped here. Timeout. It's the defense calling the timeout here. It'll be their third and final timeout, so as they talk things over, we'll step aside. And this one is right down Broadway. And that will extend that lead. Something extraordinary, something crazy here in the closing stages. That field goal should just about put this one on ice.
Brandon, this will be a great win for them. The better team's going to win this game, no question about it.
The Chargers offense now. They get set to head back on the field. They might be thinking this is close to a lost cause here. Got to play it out. What do they need to do?
Well, they have a thought process in mind already, but they can't get ahead of themselves. They know that they need to score quickly.
Yeah, two-score game.
Onside kick and get the ball back and then score again. But they can't worry about the last 2 points. The only thing that matters is scoring quickly. Then they'll take it from there.
Here we go.
To throw is Bortles. He's going to let it fly. And this is intercepted. And that should do it. A great read and it's picked off. We'll hit a run.
This is disappointing, but you have to go for broke here. Down 2 scores. Tim, I should admit some throws you definitely wouldn't want to make. But I think this interception is going to pretty much write an end to this one.
So an extra defensive back on the field. They need a stop here on third and goal.
3-19! 3-19!
Well, as always, partner, an extreme pleasure to share a booth with you. I have to say, I am impressed at your discipline because you came here and you said you were not going to eat any of the media buffet. You made it to the end. You didn't consume a single calorie.
I appreciate that. What you missed is me going to the concession stand outside of your eyesight and getting it done that way. Look, I mean, they were serving the good stuff. I had to do it.
Oh, man, but you're svelte in good shape, but you cheated a little bit. We'll let it slide.
I appreciate that. Always a pleasure to work with you.
Coming, troubles in the air. Troubles in the air.
feel it coming, troubles in the air.
We set the roof on fire. We set the roof on fire. We set the roof. We set the roof. We set the roof on fire. We set the roof. We set the roof. We set the roof on fire.
If I'm not mistaken, yeah. Home team made. Two threes on my feet, then I pump fake. Baby girl, grab the crew. What if kiss it? Sweat leave, Mr. Couldn't took it quicker. Yeah. Hottest on the planet, get the place lit up. Yeah. Fly, got expensive taste, sight into. Yeah. We ain't on the same team, cheer up. Yeah. Bunch of that make sit up. Sit up. I ain't come to blend in, boy, I stand out. Yeah. Money talks, you just popping off at the mouth. If I'm the topic, then the conversation heated. Ray Shrimp getting booked up in every city. Splash up with cash, had the spaz on the waiter. She messed up my order 3 times in a row. Whoa. I'm good on gas, I just filled up my tank. Now let's fill up her head and let's see if she goes.
We set the roof on fire. 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 We set the roof.
Sliding down the line.